WNBC. This is Spia Magazine, and I'm Mike Cherry. And tonight we are at the studios of WNBC Radio. A little bit later on in the show, you're going to meet Don Imus. And tonight on Spia Magazine, we'll tell you about something new in music. Yes, tonight we'll visit the world of music television and discover why cable TV's latest offering is a real treat. Then we'll meet America's favorite advice lady, Dear Abby, and we'll meet WNBC Radio's advice person, Dr. Carl Schultz. Also tonight, Linda Harris attends a real Hawaiian luau, and New York sanitation man Al Fagoni shows us where he learned to speak Japanese in just a single day. So learn about music television next here on PM Magazine. Story tonight on Fia Magazine. I'm in Teaneck, New Jersey at Teaneck High School. And don't they love it?
Yeah.
And for our first story tonight, we have a story about the hottest thing on cable television, and it's called
MTV!
The reason for all the commotion on this Teaneck, New Jersey high school campus is this man. He's J.J. Jackson, and J.J. is a star on MTV.
Roll it, please. Okay, I'll make 2 and 5. Might be up to...
J.J. Jackson is a VJ, a video jock on music television, the hottest thing on cable TV. Beamed by satellite to over 300 cable systems across the country. And MTV fans say it's music to their eyes.
MTV combines two major influences in our lives. One, music. And the other, television. Put the two together and you've got MTV.
Rod Stewart can be yours tonight, or any night, actually, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. In fact, video performances by rock acts have been the main component of Warner Amex's MTV since last August, when it first took off.
MTV, music television, the world's first video rock and roll channel in stereo. J.J. Jackson going to show you Quarter Flash, Todd Rundgren, The Police. Plus, we've got tour information for the mighty J. Giles Band. Platinum Logic. Speaking of Great Britain,
like J.J. says, MTV is basically an FM radio-style progressive rock station on television. And J.J. isn't the only VJ.
Woohoo! Music from Adam Ant. I'm Martha Quinn.
Alan Hunter with you, and I'm going to lay back, take it easy on this Wednesday, and tell you about some music news.
This is MTV Music Television. I'm Nina Blackwood, and here we go with some music news for you.
Spirits in the Material World, that is music from The Police. You're with Mark Goodman at MTV.
And it was Mark Goodman, who was the world's first VJ to hit the air.
Reunion. I've always thought of it as 20 or 30 or 40 years from now, I will be the answer to a trivia question. I'm excited to be on the ground floor of what is, I've said this before, what I think could be the future of rock and roll.
Why do you think MTV is so popular?
Well, mainly because it's the first and only place that you could see video music. You could hear it in stereo. It's on all the time. It's on 24 hours a day. It's very special. It's very special.
Why do you like to be a part of it?
Because I love rock and roll.
The Police are on a lot, the Who's on a lot.
Like a lot of the punk things are really like neat to watch.
I don't like it at all because I don't watch it. It's the greatest thing to come along in a century.
They're just totally mesmerized by the fact that they can see these artists.
Les Garland is not a music television VJ. He's a Warner Amex VP, which still stands for Vice President.
They dazzle. REO Speedwagon right in the sticks. Boom, boom, one right after another. They're watching for 30 minutes to an hour at a time.
What response do you get from radio stations?
I think I'm in trouble.
What's it doing to radio stations? In most cases, we're helping radio stations.
It's just another form of music. So we don't see ourselves competing with radio at all.
Lindsay Buckingham right there. He is in some trouble on MTV. I'm Martha Quinn. Tonight we got a real special thing happening. Eastern time between 10 and 11. It's on JJ's show. You got it. We are picking the winner for the MTV Devo Hawaiian Holiday.
Contests, celebrity interviews, and of course, rock and roll. It's all specialized programming to a particular audience, and MTV is after the 12 to 34 age group.
We're not into time and temperature and la la la. You know, it's more relaxed.
Now, this is called Runaway Camera, not your normal television fare, but it's MTV's innovation, which has helped to spread the word and the music around the country.
In markets such as Des Moines, Iowa, where we have a very good penetration, I mean, 95% of the people in Des Moines are aware of this, according to our research.
And even though the Big Apple is home for MTV, most of New York and Los Angeles, the two major media centers of the nation, don't have MTV because channels are not available on the cable systems. But MTV is waiting on its cable friends to come across soon. Future looks good. They plan live concerts and someday soon to broadcast live 24 hours a day.
But they could get some soul on, but they said they'll have that in the future.
Other music organizations already have a soul channel on cable in the works for early next year and country western soon after that. But now that MTV has paved the way, who knows what's going to happen next.
At the moment, it's a monster that we really don't know where it's going to go in 10 years.
In 5 years, where will MTV be?
Household word. I really think that MTV will be a household word.
Well, it might. Okay.
Well, that's music television, and this, of course, is Don Imus on WNBC Radio. What do you think of music television? Not you've heard about it.
I love Martha Quinn.
She is nice, isn't she?
She lives in my building, and I usually go down there about 2 o'clock in the morning, try to get some wine and borrow cigarettes, and she won't let me in.
Oh, really? You know, she's pretty young.
Yeah, let's not get into that. I have to put up with enough grief about that.
Okay, so do you think music television's going to hurt radio?
It's going to kill radio.
Is it?
It's the end of radio.
So you're finished, basically.
I'm sorry. Goodbye.
Okay, we're finished, too. We'll be back in just a little bit.